Alright, I made their water warmer. I'm gonna put some more on there. They actually don't even need any more in here, but I like it when I see them float. They're so cute. Like, Goldie just lets her back little legs float. They got their shed coming off in the water. Oh, healthy little baby. Let me get some water on your face. Mm-hmm. Oh, you see those little droplets going in their eyes? They need that. Because their eyelids, they shed too. Like, one day, like, I was looking at my baby's eyes, and they started getting, like, really weird, and, like, a film over them, and then they started getting, like, really puffy. Like, it just scared me, because I didn't really know, like, that reptiles do that. But, like, not only shed their body and their, like, legs and their feet and their toes, and right here by their neck and their whole head and their eyeballs. Like, literally, they shed their eyeballs. I mean, not their eyeballs, but their eyelids. They shed their eyelids. Ooh, my little babies. Oh, there goes a tail wag. We got a tail wagger. Come on, Goldie, start wagging your tail. I wonder, like, I just, like, wonder why all of a sudden he's, like, started wagging. Look, she's a wagger. This is crazy. It's, like, so fucking cute. Like, when she started doing it inside her enclosure, I was, like, wondering, is she about to poop? Or, like, because I gotta get her off that cover. I don't want her to poop on the cover. But, like, then there was no poop. And I kept on seeing this little tail wag thing. And I'm like, what is that? Like, is there something wrong? But, I mean, there's nothing wrong. It's just, I guess she's feeling very good. So, it's a sign that I'm doing something right. She's so happy. Goldie, you really think you're gonna make it? No, you're not. It's too high up. She be trying it though. She's a high hop. She hops like really high. I was gonna say she's a high hopper. I don't know if that makes sense, but she hops really high. And you know what I noticed? They like observe their crickets, and like when they're not ready to eat them, they just like put their head sideways and they like stare at them and stuff. And no, little baby, it's not time. It's not time to get out yet. Okay. Oh yeah, so they observe them. Like, when they're not ready to eat, they just stare at the crickets and they observe them. And they, like, copy their movements. So you know how, like, have you ever seen the crickets move, like, so, like, skittish, and they move, like, really weird, and all of a sudden they want to, like, hop and stuff? Well, like, I noticed that my little baby dragons are, like, picking up the behavior from the crickets. It's so funny because, like, they're not crickets. And it's, like, weird behavior. Because they're reptiles, and they be acting all skittery, jittery, like crickets, and then all of a sudden they try to hop up. You see that? Look at how special. Oh, you seen that? You like, so randomly when they feel extra good, they start to like kind of bully each other, and like sometimes they'll jump up on each other and then jump on top of the head part and then dunk each other's head inside the water, which is like, I don't let it continue happening. I always pull them off of each other. But they do it so harmlessly. Like, they never have tried to, like, nip at each other or anything like that. Oh, my baby likes to swim. You like swimming. That's so fun. Anyways, I think it's really about time for them to get out, even though I love it when I see her tail wag. Oh my god, it's the most cutest thing. I don't even force it. Like, even when I'm touching her, she does it by herself. Oh, we got Goldie tail wagging. Goldie's tail wagging. Yeah, like, they observe each other's behaviors, and then they do it. They, like, synchronize with each other. Okay, every time I say I'm gonna stop recording, like, I can't help but keep on recording. Because, like, when I least expect it, that's when they, like, do these really random, behaviors. Characteristics. Okay, so, to just be informative a bit in this video, I learned that even like when they're shedding and they're, it looks like their shed can like come off, do not assist them and pull off the shed. Let it come off by itself, because if you pull off the shed, well, like even though it looks like it's ready to come off because it's hanging, if you pull it off too soon, it can cause them to have like an open fresh cut. So it's like pulling off a scab. When you pull off a scab, your cut is fresh. Well, yeah, so when you pull off their shed, it can cause them to like get a wound. Or like, not a wound, but like, I don't know how to like describe that, but like, just don't take off their shed when it's not supposed to be taken off like by a physical person. Like, let it come off by its own self, even if it's hanging, because that's just how it's supposed to go. Just let them naturally do their thing and all will be fine, because you can actually cause an open like wound situation even though they're not wounded. It's just their bottom skin is still in the process of developing, so like we don't want to do that. But like, so like if I like touch it, I'm touching his tail, but not to take off the shed. I'm just touching her. I call her him sometimes, like a lot of the time. They're freaking it. They're both girls. Oh, she's starting to do it a little bit. Not really that much. Come on, babe. Swim. 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 Alright, I gotta take them out. I just have to stop this recording. But I can't help it. But I'm really gonna stop now. So we'll check up in when I am like on camera. Focus. When I'm like feeding them veggies, I'll record more. Aww, you just gave her a kissy? So cute! What a perfect way to end the video. Mm-hmm.